Alright then, everyone, hello, and welcome back to another episode of Brave New World Blindfolded. First things first, one thing I forgot to do last time was to make a proper save state after I finished the segment, so I ended up not saving it. I did my best to recreate exactly what I did the first time, though, so hopefully I didn't make any mistakes in that regard. If I did make any mistakes, it's probably just a penalty for me, really. So, first off, I want to skills, equip, Sabin's at the bottom, equip, top slot, okay, good, just double checking. And I want to shove the dark gear on him. I'm not really sure whether the 6 speed is going to make more of a difference than the 2 stamina. I'd guess so. 5 defense is almost nothing, really. One step to the right. 1, 2, 3. All the way to the left. Let's see, did I make it to the cave? Yep, just as expected. If I messed that up, it would have been a pretty sad thing to do. Well, except, well, that's my preparations done anyway. Might as well just get in front of the cave, make restarts as quick as possible. Okay, let's continue. I'm not sure what happened last time. I just suddenly moved up by mistake for some reason. Thankfully, it wasn't too far in. 1, 2. Hello, Siegfried, the fake version. I'm sure I could. This party could fairly easily kick the crud out of the real Siegfried, let alone a fake, so. Just winging it there. Hoping to pause during the screen transition. Like, stop walking. Personally, I think, okay. It's much easier than. Just counting steps, and if I did it wrong, I'll get an indication soon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that lines me up very nicely. In both my BFLG route and this one, it lines me up very nicely, so. This is 7. Well, it looks like something provoked the wrath of Celeste. Oh, and something just hits Celeste with that, so this attack's not going to be doing a whole lot. The danger for Celeste is that if she gets imped, her attacks become a lot less useful. And if she gets poisoned, that's unfortunate too. Remedy to her, and I'll have Sabin. As you'll notice, remedies are at the top. That's because they're probably the most useful item in my inventory right now. Remedies are super good in this game. I don't even really like the spell remedy, because generally I prefer to just get people off the statuses quickly rather than wait for the remedy to fire off. Because I find, as long as I'm just using the item, things aren't likely to go wrong, but if I'm just using the spell, the extra healing can sometimes come in handy, but not always. Especially not in a blindfolded run, it's less likely here. It's really hard to put the spell remedy to effective use. 1, 2, 3. Then all the way to the left. I could have gotten away going to the chest without counting steps there, but walking back from it, it would be a pretty big pain in the butt, so I'm certainly not doing it that way. Down, not very far. Left, all the way. Battle, again. It was probably like on the last step. Alright, you're still using items, that's kind of a important thing to know. Hello, Sabin. If Celeste is having a good fight, she can just rip everything to shreds. Yeah, like, 2 enemies down, or 1 enemy down, and Firestorm, hello. But if Celeste is having a bad fight, she's probably not going to be doing a whole lot. If she gets imped, that is. Okay, nothing crazy there. I'm alright with that. No poison, no imp. No powerful attacks except presumably Firestorm, but that's what my region's for, to keep me alive through stuff like that. Hello, X Potion. I need as many of those as I can get my hands on, because those are very helpful. And I expended so many in the Atma weapon fight. I need to start stocking back up on those things again. Back out the way I came, which is what's nice about this route. Why memorize something twice when you could just memorize it once and do it twice? So. Up. That's why I altered my route to count steps on the way there as well. There's only one caveat that I have to remember on the way back. And that's that I run into another notch here, so I gotta take a step back out and then walk down the staircase, so. One, two, three. And now I'm lined back up with where I would be in my BFLG, so for the whole 2 seconds that'll happen. Before I go off again to get another chest. Well, that's one thing dead. That's another thing dead. Wow. Celeste is, like I said, sometimes she's just going AWOL. Sabin's just like, hey, you didn't even give me a chance there. How am I going to show people how buff I am when you're just murdering everything with those rising suns you have? She'd be even more powerful with a Kisarigama backing her up in the second slot, but. So now I walk up and write for a bit. The chests in here actually don't add as much difficulty as you might expect having to get them, because the chests are actually the most nicely lined up things in this place, so. There we go. So that's my, whatever that is. Ether? Maybe? Not sure. And then I just run all the way back to the left, and I'm exactly where I would be if I was coming through here without getting the chest, which is just so convenient. I cannot even say. All the way up. Now there's a rock here, and I just need to go around the rock. I hear some punching noises, but punching noises aren't too bad, especially if they're hitting Celeste, because she's likely killing stuff because of those. But it doesn't seem like she counterattacked with either of. Oh, never mind. I remembered my characters in the wrong order of which way I set them up. Nothing crazy there, nope. No poisons, nothing that could kill me, so I'm just gonna keep running. Now here's a rock, I need to go around the rock. It's a very complicated principle, I know. Back around the rock. Okay, now I should be at the top of the screen. So if I walk left, I hit the cliff face here. Walk all the way down. I hit the black darkness area. And then walk back to the left. This is probably the hardest part of the route to visualize, I think, the whole thing, really. Now, I need to take one step down and start taking left and ups. So eventually, I'll get to the point where I'm inside the Holy Rod room. Well, it's thankful here, but going through here, if I were just going straight to Garrett, the fact that left and up doesn't take me into the next room would be a pain in the butt, like it wasn't my BFLG. But the way it is here, it just allows me to coast all the way here to the Holy Rod room with no issues. So I'm definitely not complaining about that. I'm surprised. I think I made it there without any fights. So yeah, now I just go right and down till I reach the holy rod chest. So I think I'm going down on my next step. Down, down, left for AuraBolt. AuraBolt? What? That's not even a thing. Oh, that thing just died. Someone just got smacked on my side. But those physical attacks from the things in this cave, they just can't do enough to keep up with my regen. They're pretty much a non-factor, let's be honest here. It's only their special attacks that are gonna give me pause. That was Aqua Rake. So all I've got left is one Cruller. And he is surprisingly not dead. At least I think Aqua Rake is one of those moves that only gets used with one enemy in the... Ending with an Aqua Rake. Do I want to keep walking, or do I want to... Skills, Sless, Magic, Cure. Yeah, I probably could have just kept walking. Let's be honest here. Down. Now I just keep going to the chest. Any second now. Uh-oh, starting to get worried. Uh-oh, that's not good. So let's just think. What could I have done wrong? I'm gonna go up and right a few times. Now go down and right. Yeah, good. Okay. What went wrong was probably what I thought it might be, which was I went down after that battle when I wasn't supposed to and got stuck in that one little spot. None the worse for wear in that case. There's only literally one other chest in this cave, so not even a chance that I somehow wormed my way to the wrong chest. And by being one other chest, I mean this is the only chest that was left at that point. That's one thing dead. It's two things dead. Probably. Oh, Celeste is going to town again. Yay, that battle's over. Piece of cake. Now let's just go up and left. Until I reach the... Another fight, no big deal. The worst thing is when a fight generally interrupts an up and left. That is often the worst thing. Bolt 2 counterattack, that's not good. This battle will require some healing. Oh yeah, follow it up with an Aqua Rake, that's not good at all. Thankfully, Sabin appears to be alive. And Celeste is still alive, so as long as it dies now... Oh, there's something else left. I didn't think there was. Well, now apparently there isn't something else left, so that's easy. Gonna need some healing at least. Skills, less magic, cure. Two cure spells, and that pain was down for the count. Thankfully, this room is surprisingly flat, despite what it might look like. Which helps out a lot. Looks like all the same craggy sort of rocks that was in the other room, but it's actually pretty square. So I probably made it now. I'm glad I got the battle there, because now hopefully it won't come when I'm counting steps. Back one. One, two, three, 4, screen transition, gotta note it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I run all the way to the right, and it'll line me up with the cutscene I'm about to enter. I appear to be hearing noises on the left side. I hope I did not attack myself. Okay. Never mind. Maybe I'm getting confused somehow. I'm not sure. I'm just gonna have Sless hold the button just in case. Hunters do that, right? I think they do. If so, that's not a big deal. Oh, that's the end of that. Nothing crazy happens. So now I can just continue going. Thankfully, the one space gap between the height of the wall on the left and the height of the wall on the right means I can just run into the wall on the right. And very conveniently end up going through this door. Now, if I'm correct, there should be a cutscene now. Good. I already had one issue this segment. I don't want another one. Those are always annoying. Things don't work out as expected, and it's just kind of like, okay, now panic mode, what do I do now? Alright, so I get walked to a very convenient spot in the room, so I can just go left to reach the thing here. And then go left again after going around the water. Run up to the turtle, and now I press the button for a long time. With some luck, I might get a battle on the other side to tell me when I've actually made it. That would be the best case scenario, really. Because that would tell me exactly when I'm across. Whereas otherwise, I have to press the button for a while, because the turtle could be anywhere in its cycle, and it moves rather slowly. So I'm probably here now, provided I didn't somehow miss the turtle, which would suck. But at least I'll get caught somewhere that I know. One left, and straight into the battle. Couldn't have come two steps earlier. I swear, what is that noise that's the attacking noise that's coming on the left side of the screen? Like, I can't even think of what that would be. Unless it's actually coming on the right and I'm just not hearing properly, but it's confusing the crud out of me. I swear I would have caught something like this while I was testing, but all the way left. All the way left again. This one's a little bit longer, but still not super long. Especially not with dash. This one's short. Now the next one's long enough that I really should have a battle. One down, all the way left. And I did not get a battle, so I'm still not panicking yet, though. It's not that far. Not like the end of the floating continent where I somehow ran a ridiculously far distance. And after the fourth left, I have to go up and left. And now I go down and left. Alright, if I did not make any mistakes, this should be the last fight of the cave. Pretty decent cave run, I'd say. So far, I mean, The Humpties haven't been hitting me with the imp status very much. I think it happened once. So it was a lot worse during testing. They seem to be hitting me with it left and right. And that's the end of that. So yeah, hopefully the last battle before I get out of this cave. All the way to the left. The segment is long, and it has a boss right at the end of a dungeon without a save point in the middle, but it's fairly standard. Hello, Figaro. This random patch of safety in the middle of an otherwise full-on dungeon. All the way down. Just to get out of this jail cell. Gotta get out of jail. I mean, I think I've got a pretty decent chance. I mean, I've been good behavior, really, so. So walking up and left, actually, somehow, I was actually a little bit surprised, managed to bring me up to the clock up here, behind the corpse. Unfortunately, I can't just walk out of Figaro, that would just be too nice. Instead, there's people blocking the doors that are otherwise still completely valid doors. If you walk through walls, you can get to the doors and enter them. So Figaro's not buried as far as the game is concerned, but these two douchebags are just blocking the way. What rude people. How impolite. Now, two screen transitions there, so just gotta be careful, because even though I'm dashing now, it's not gonna be about twice as fast as the LLG. And then I walk around a railing. Walk around the railing. And here we are in the second half of this dungeon. There's one enemy in here that I don't feel I've gotten as much experience with as I did the other enemies in the South Figaro cave. It's the robot guy that falls from the sky that was ripped. It was originally somewhere else in vanilla, but was clearly put in this dungeon because there's not a whole lot of stuff in this dungeon. Otherwise, I mean, it would be the same stuff as before, and it just wouldn't be anything new. So the first part, very simple, just walk around in a C shape. And then that takes me straight to the second room. Now I can walk downward. Uh-oh, still kind of surprised I haven't gotten a fight, but I would be also surprised if I messed that up somehow. The complicated stuff is going to come in a little bit. Unlike the cave, which was kind of difficult in some ways because there's so many nooks and crannies and everything was so uneven, it was very easy to run off into the middle of nowhere. Good, I didn't mess that up. I just got a long time without a battle. This place is sometimes difficult for the complete opposite reason, because it's so straight, there's nothing to run into sometimes, so I've just got no option other than counting steps. I made it another walk without a battle. That's okay. I don't mind getting probably a third of the way through this without a fight. Still going. I'll get another indication in 2 seconds. Alright. Just gotta count steps here. Oh yeah, now some of the battle's gonna come. 1, 2, 3. I'm at the foot of the staircase. Just gotta remember that. Has less attack. 1 to the left. There were 3 attacks so far. 1 was a punch, so I'm thinking they might be Nope, they're definitely not the robot guys. Celeste wouldn't have taken them out that easily. They're a little bit too tanky for Celeste to go at them with just a normal swing. However, she keeps up with her current damage on them when she decides to go chucking things. And, I mean, she's kind of throwing things as it is right now, really. But, I mean like the super throw that she does. Alright, I'm at the foot of the staircase, so I gotta go 1 up to get onto the staircase, and then I need to walk up the staircase. Up and left to get to the door. This dungeon's really weird. It's just the dimensions of it. So cramped. But, which means that every time I move, I'm that much closer to getting another indication of where I am. Like, everything's so cramped together. It's sort of nice, because walking long distances without indications is always nerve-wracking, but there's nothing dangerous about this area. Except possibly the enemies. So now I walk around there. And now that I'm at the foot of the staircase again, I can just leave this. Another fight. At this rate, I'll probably only get one more fight before the tentacles. Here's hoping this is more Humpties, because those guys suck. Imp status is pretty much just delaying, wasting my time. Poison. It's their strongest attack, but it's still kind of meh. Alright, I'm thinking... if it might be the robot guys... yes, it's the robot guys. Which might be dangerous, because now I have only one surviving at fairly low HP. I mean, fairly high HP. I don't care if he's low. But if he's high, he can exploder my face off. Yep, there's that exploder. Whatever, probably killed whoever got hit by it. Let's be honest here. Item save, just want to double check. Phoenix down a second from the top. Oh, apparently it didn't kill anyone. That works. Skills, Celeste, magic. Oh, she probably got imped. Whatever. Okay, now I'm confused. Oh wait, I probably checked Sabin's menu. Derp. Skills, Celeste, magic, cure. Yep, now things are as expected. Run all the way down. And then I gotta go back up 3. 1, 2, 3. Thanks to this room's symmetricality, I only have to remember one value. Now I just need to remember that there's one space between the chest and the arch, and we're good. So I've pretty much reached the boss fight. We'll see whether I actually make it to the boss fight, or whether... that's door number one. What's behind door number two? Oh, tentacles! That's not a good thing to find. Okay, random encounter. In this room. I hope there's nothing crazy in this room, because I don't think I tested a single time. I heard that smack on the left. Okay. Better not mess around with moving Celeste's cursor, because this is definitely a back attack. Oh, I think I just got imped. Perhaps I should have paid attention before using Celeste's attack. But mistakes aren't fatal here. In fact, since this is quadruple Humpties, it's certainly very far from fatal. It's the tentacles battle, equipping myself beforehand, that could definitely be fatal. Or if I go in on poison, that would be a horrible, horrible mistake. I need to make sure I am very much set up correctly for this fight. You know what, I'm going to just continue attacking even though it won't do a whole lot, just because I don't want to mess up my cursors before the tentacles. Not for these idiots. Or rather, this idiot, because there's only one left. Gotta get my grammar correct. Subject, verb... I forget the word for it. Agreement? I don't know. Seven will take him out anyway. Then I can just heal in the menu. Alright, I want to be very careful tabbing through this. I don't want to pull an eye for it and accidentally start up the battle by mistake. I'm pretty sure I'm very close to it. If not, right next to Edgar, so... alright, so this is safe. Alright, first things first. No, I did not need a Phoenix Down. I did not expect to need a Phoenix Down. I did expect to need a Remedy. Skills, Celeste, magic, cure. Gotta be at full HP. I mean, I really don't, but... we'll just say I do. Skills, Sabin, up to Esper's. Gotta move carefully and select Golem. There's Golem. He'll be handy. He'll nerf the Tentacles' physical attacks, and that's a lot of what they have left for offense. They've got Tentacle, which is clearly a timed attack, and but it's not frequent enough to kill me, not through my obscene region right now. And they've got their trademark seizing. That's it. So, badly timed combination of those two things could definitely cause some sticky scenarios that I wish to heavily avoid, because I do not want to take any risks in this fight after having to go through a dungeon to get here. So what else was I going to do? Relics. Item, skills, equip, relic. It doesn't matter who I'm equipping. Equip, top slot. 1, 2, 3. And the second character. Equip, top slot. 1, 2, 3, 4. It doesn't matter which character I de-equip, because both the black belt and the ribbon are unique in my inventory as far as what I have. So, there's no possibility that, well, in either case, the relic would be filtered to the bottom, and I have to remember that I have to do 4 ups the second time. So anyway, the tentacle fight. Hello, tentacles. First, I gotta go through this cutscene, but there's obviously no need to bend any tricks, seeing as it, well, I should do it once, just for the sake of making sure that I'm actually triggering the cutscene and not just sitting there pressing A somehow. Because that would be awkward. Alright, fight time. I get the first turn here. It's a very nice thing. Drill on the top. So 7. What was I gonna do with 7? Oh yeah, summon Golem. What? Oh, right. I'm an idiot. I was on Blitz, obviously. And Celeste is still on attack because that's what I did earlier. So, Celeste, you attack that thing. Hopefully Edgar makes it to his second turn. That would be a very handy thing, because then I'd get one drill off on the right set of tentacles for sure. That's what the reflect rings are good for, and it's nice to have confirmation that I did that correctly. Golem, that protects me from a great deal of stuff. This is Celeste. Edgar blocked. No, that was probably Golem, let's face it. Oh, Edgar got seized. That's not helpful. But it's better. Well, I guess it might be better than my other characters getting seized. So this is Savin, he's in his magic menu. Let's try to set seizure. The top left tentacle is my first target for death, but I want to set seizure on the right one so that they're dying. Yeah, that was a rightward tentacle. I want to set the seizure on the rightward tentacle so they're dying while I'm also killing the other one. My golem won't last forever, and things get hairier when it dies, so. Left, right, left. So hopefully he'll hit the right side again. AuraBolt would be stronger, but setting seizure is pretty important, so. That was another right side tentacle. I wanted to hit one more right side tentacle attack before I start using AuraBolt instead. Oh no, you did nothing with your raid. Originally, I was tossing up using the blood sword in this fight, but I was like, you know what? No, I'm not gonna. Okay, someone got seized. That's not good. It's probably Celeste, I think. No, it was Savin. Hopefully that top tentacle will die soon. And hopefully Savin will be put back down. I can't tell when he gets put back down, so that's one awkward thing about this. Oh, I think he got put back down already. Left, right, left. I still have not heard any of the tentacles die. But maybe this one's close? Yes. I was indeed correct about that. Rightward tentacle, there's 2 to 3 chance. Ugh, leftward tentacle, the only one left. And unfortunately, well, his raid reflects, what do I care? Tentacle. Is that the first time you've hit me all game? I did not hear that. What am I doing? Click the top one. That's my order. Oh, right. I forgot to pummel again. Well, hopefully, seizure's been set correctly. So now I'm playing the game where I try to kill the two rightward tentacles. It's kind of ironic. This is completely the opposite order of the BFLLG. Top left tentacle dies first here, the right two die second, and the bottom left one dies last, whereas in the BFLLG it was the complete opposite way. Seven's left, which is okay because, you know, pretty easy to use seven correctly. Rightward tentacle, that's good. I want the damage on them, because they're the next slated to die. The last one will go down easily once I know that the other two are gone. I swear that they're putting down the characters faster than they did in my test run, which I'm certainly not going to complain about. It makes less chance of Tentacle killing them off after a seize. Seize alone shouldn't be enough to take him out, though. Another rightward Tentacle? Tentacle, okay. Tentacle's the most dangerous thing, but both my characters are still alive, so things are going okay still. What was that? I swear it sounded like a Celeste attack one time. This sure feels like it's going on for longer, though, this fight, so that's not a good sign. Okay, someone else got seized. Hopefully whichever tentacle did the seizing is about to die. Wow, okay. That's another one down. So, it's gotta be the one at the top that died, I'm almost certain of that. If not, this might get awkward because Celeste will be attacking herself, and that's no use. Left. Left, right, left. If it hits a rightward tentacle, the one remaining rightward tentacle this time, I'll know that it has seizure for sure. Which is good. Yep, okay. The last remaining tentacle does indeed have seizure. I really hope I'm not attacking the- oh, it's dead. Alright, just one tentacle remaining. The danger is his spells get stronger. Oh no! But I just happen to have reflect rings to prevent that. What luck! And of course, he's got region, which means he's the tankiest of the tentacles. In theory. And I say in theory, because now that he's the only one left, I feel pretty okay just blowing him away with Bolt 2. So this will do heaping helpings of damage. Edgar, you can stay on the floor. Did I forget to press that one extra time? Oh, what did I do? That's not right. That sounded like a revivify or something. If that's the case, then I don't really care. If it was a Phoenix tier, that would suck. I guess. Yeah, I am in my item menu. I jerked that up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not sure what exactly I did there, but to get to the item menu. I really hope that was just a revivify. Oh, right, I forgot. Runic isn't available, that's why. Annoying with commands that are there sometimes and aren't there other times. Whatever, this guy's done. He can't. All he's got left is tentacle. And that's not gonna help him. It's too little too late. Golem's probably still up, I think. And he's dead. Nice. Well, I can revive Edgar, I suppose. For whatever help he'll be. And I also have to shove an Esper on him. I'm not gonna bother with relics. Don't care about relics. I just don't want him leveling up and wasting an Esper level. So any second now, the Siege will stop blabbing, and the Figaro music will play. Opening the menu here, which I'll be doing by default anyhow, will close the door, just as it did outside the cafe in Nikea. So I will get an indication of when I'm going in the door, not that I needed it, because... let's be honest, there's a whole one step till I get the door after the fight, but... shut up, I don't care about the life story of these thieves. Especially because I can't see it. Alright. So now, let's just determine where my save menu is. Got all the time in the world. Oh yeah, I was on Relic, wasn't I? So, yeah, no wonder it took so long. Phoenix down. And now I heal up with Celeste. Skills, Celeste, magic, cure. What? Oh yeah, right. I'm an idiot, I just did the same thing, like, 5 minutes ago. Whoops. Whatever, I don't need the MP. I'm pretty solid on the MP from what I've had happen so far. Because I didn't have to heal much in the cave. Is that it? Is that all I needed? No. Stupid. Seven. You should still be on Espers. That stray, just as I expected. Skills. Edgar, you are not on Espers, so... whoops, I think I did that improperly. Skills, Edgar, Espers, down at the bottom. Yeah, I have to press the button twice, otherwise it gives me an indication of absolutely nothing. Shove Golem on the Edgar, and... now it is time to start walking. I'm not going to bother re-equipping relics. My relic selection isn't super good, but it'll certainly get me through this dungeon, especially now that I have a bonus character. Around the chest. Hello, Soul Saver. Around the chest. And now, let's start walking back down. Should only be one or two battles before I get out of this place. Managed to make it down probably the longest stretch of walking. Not yet. Screen transitions were throwing me off. But that's why I wait. You could be either Edgar or Sabin. But now you must be Sabin. Celeste. Oops, don't want to bolt too. Actually... you know what? I do want a bolt, too. Let's live a little. If it's those trapper guys, it might help out a little. I can switch up to Bio Blaster. Which is... top right, I think? I don't know. I never really paid that much attention to it in the Tentacles fight, and I didn't really care about Edgar's existence. So... oh, Noise Blaster. That works too. I'm not sure if the Noise Blaster has any effectiveness at all here, so I'm just going to attack. And I'm being an idiot because that's still not the attack command. Okay, I think the battle's over. When Celeste decides she's gonna murder things, she really decides to murder things. And when I use my bolt too, it helps as well. Especially against those guys, which are clearly gonna be weak to it. I don't know what their magical defenses are like, but... oh, striking a weakness should be decent enough whether their magic defenses are bad or good. Besides, since when do robots have good... magic defenses? Run all the way up to the top. I'll probably get one more battle before I get out of here. But other than that, I'm home free. It's a good thing these guys don't use exploder multi-target, or they could be very dangerous. They could wipe my party very easily if the wrong set of things happened. Down on the left. And that brings me very close to the exit of Figaro. Probably haven't made it yet. Nope. That's probably the last fight, so if things go well here... Attack. Huh? Whose turn is this? What's going on? I would have thought it was... I thought Celeste was the only person on that noise, though. I thought she just went. Maybe I messed up Edgar, then. Don't really care about him anyway. just attack? Well, I probably did a ton of damage unless she got imped. Oh wait, maybe I might be messing some things up because Edgar might be imped, but... Or he might be dead, I don't know. Yeah, it seems to me like Edgar's imped, but he's not really relevant here right now. Which is ironic, because he was always the MVP in the World of Balance, but for the moment, being... not really super well equipped is not helping him in the least. Yep, that's that out of the way. I should be fairly close to the bottom here. So I'm fairly certain I'll get out without another fight. And then I just gotta go run back up 3. That's probably good enough. 1, 2, 3, foot of the staircase, one more, and right and up. As expected, no menu opening, so I am good. Now, as long as I don't go too quickly here, I don't want to accidentally talk to this guy and end up messing myself up royally later. So yeah, now I go to Kolingjin to avoid having to take an extra trip down into this room. I will, I think, according to what I kind of know about newer versions of Brave New World, need to be coming it back into Figaro. Even if I'm not going to be going it back into this room. So it's not as quite as nice a time saver as it is in my LLG to do this right now, but, you know, it's not as if it costs anything to do it right now either, so... Ugh. 1, 2, 3. And now, I'm pretty much home free. Just gotta go right and down, and I shall exit the castle. Made it. Alright. That was probably the worst segment before I get the airship out of all of them, and I'm being an idiot now. ...47 minutes. Long, but not too bad for a segment that wasn't too difficult to succeed at. See you next time!